Hello everybody, this is Angie and I have four projects that I just finished. They are all for fall and I created these things using items from the Dollar Tree and things that I already had in my craft room or the garage. And I bought, I think, maybe one extra thing, and I'll mention that when I'm at that project. But this is my favorite because it was so easy. This is a pillow that I made for one of our chairs with two very pretty placements that I found in the Dollar Tree. And here you can see where I went a little bit off on the outer edge over here. But I want to give a shout out to a nice lady by the her YouTube channel is Pretty N, the letter N as in no, Flawed. That's PrettyNFlawed, because in a couple of years ago she did these. She made some for fall and she made some for Christmas. And what she did, and this is what's so wonderful, she used a glue gun. She didn't sew it, she used a glue gun. And what she did say when she was showing how to do it is, when you're taking the glue, don't go all the way to the very edge. Go about inside here and you make that nice edge to it. She did a much better job than me. This was my first and only one. But it goes fast, it goes simple. And for filler, I bought this stuff at the last Christmas clearance. It's called Buffalo Snow. Let's see if I could show that. Buffalo Snow. And it's a huge bag. And I always use fiberfill for different things. And I think this was like $1.50 on clearance. And I looked at what it really read, you know, what it really was. And it's fiberfill. That's all it is. And it's softer, so it's much nicer to use for these pillows. But if you see the placemats in your Dollar Tree, grab a couple of them, because you only need two, of course. But I love the way this is. And I didn't overfill it because I wanted to be able to sit up in one of the chairs that we have in the living room. So this came out fun, and I really, really like it. Very, very easy to do. Okay. So I have been seeing the different colored pumpkins in every store, and of course, these were in the Dollar Tree. So what I did was I bought a couple of the neutral colors, black and white, because I knew I wanted to use my craft paints that I've had forever, and I wanted to repaint them into more neutral colors for the other pumpkins that I wanted. And what I did find is I found this gray paint, and I was just going to use this as a primer on this black one. So I found this gray paint, which I was going to use as a primer, and then I wanted to use this really bright green. So what I wound up with is this. Now, I painted the black one, this one right here, gray, and I like the way it looked. So what I did was I took my green paint and I put a few little dabs. Every once in a while I put a dab on the pumpkin, and immediately, I don't know if you can see that little bit of green in there, immediately ran my finger down it to give it a little bit of depth. And this is nothing more, this gold, because a lot of them have gold tops now. I used a gold pen that I got from Target Dollar Spot and just made this stem gold. So I have a neutralized pumpkin, and I have two more to work on, and I'll determine what colors I want those to go with. Oh, and by the way, I used a very inexpensive foamy brush. Okay, that's project number two. And of course, these are easy peasy, but I have to say that I was thrilled to see for the first time, because we, here in Northwest Louisiana, we get things so late if we get them at all. But I found the vine wreaths. They had the small one and they had this larger one. And I think I bought like three of each size. I already had the little scarecrow, because this comes two in a pack at Dollar Tree. And this is one of those kind of long viney things that you could get at Dollar Tree. So I did have to kind of secure it a bit with my glue gun. And especially this, you need a glue gun to put that on. And I'm not quite sure, but at one time Dollar Tree had glue guns. I know they still have the glue sticks, but they're relatively inexpensive in the craft stores. And use your coupon. And that is craft number 3. Now, the last one was a bit more difficult, more challenging, and I'll mention why. It's not perfect. I need to pull out a little bit. That was my, I made a sign with some fall leaves, and of course it says fall. So you can see my, I didn't do the best job with the paint and the lettering, but heck, from a distance, you can't really see that. So what did I use? Now, this is where I did have to buy something. I went into Walmart, and I got these 4-inch stencils by FolkArt. In Walmart, they were only $3.68. And the good thing about this is they're the size that you could place the word fall wherever you want on this thing, spell it out. Now, you only get one L. And that's where you can kind of see my, this L is kind of not quite lined up with the rest of them. But it still looks good from a distance, and nobody's going to get that close to anything. But if you want to do that, look in your Walmart for 4-inch letters from FolkArt in your Walmart craft section. Okay, now what did I use for the sign from Dollar Tree? Okay, first of all, for the leaves, I got the package of maple leaves from Dollar Tree. You get 50, so you get a lot of them. And for the sign, I used this that I got from Dollar Tree. I just turned it over, that's all. So you can still see the leaves, the edges of the leaves on it. And this is a Halloween sign. So when I'm finished with fall, if I'm gonna put this Halloween sign, although I did buy 2 others, I could still use it. The leaves show up a little bit on the outside, but not that much. But that's what it is. And I'll turn it over again so you can see. I could have cleaned off the glue, huh? That comes off easily. Anyway, that's my fall sign using the Beware Halloween sign from Dollar Tree. So that is it. That's all my, oops, I am sorry. I didn't mean to do that. That's my fall crafts from Dollar Tree. Well, the other things are on the side somewhere. But if you have, you know, you can find these items in your Dollar Tree and you want to go ahead and, you know, think about the things you want to do. Go ahead and give it a try. I have to say, and I've said it before, I love this one the best because it's so easy and it sits up really nice. I do repeat myself. I'm old, so I tend to do that. But I didn't overstuff it because I do like the look of the edges, and it sits up very well. It's like a stiff, thick, forgot what kind of cloth this is, but they're nice and thick. So they sit up really well in your chair or on your bed if you want to, you know, for your decor. And I just, that was my choice, not to overstuff it. And my little pumpkin, my wreath is down there, my sign is on the other side. And that is it for my Dollar Tree handmade fall decor. So, if you have any questions, please feel free to jot them down there. I'll be happy to answer them for you. Again, the lady who came up with the idea and does a video on it, her YouTube channel is Pretty. The letter N is a no, and the word flawed, F-L-A-W-E-D. So I'm giving her a really nice shout out because she really showed how to do this easily. And, okay, well, my name is Angie. I am Mary Scrapper 13 here on YouTube, and I am wishing you a wonderful creative day. Bye now.